Writing to a file by a client is fairly straightforward. What the client is doing is actually aggregating all the writes that is going on into this log segment data structure, which is in its memory. And at some point, it decides that it wants to flush this log segment and put it on the disk. And when it decides to do that, it knows the stripe group this particular log segment belongs to. And so it is going to take this log segment and stripe it on the storage servers that are part of the stripe group. So once it does this write to its stripe group, the client will notify the manager on the log segments that have been flushed to the disk so that the manager has up-to-date information about the status of the files it manages. So XFS is a research prototype of a distributed file system. There have been other instances of distributed file systems, such as the Andrew file system and the Coda file system that were built at CMU. And in fact, the Andrew file system served a community of users in the CMU campus. In a later lesson, we will return to discussing distributed file systems again. Specifically, we will look at Andrew file system and discuss the issue of security and privacy for user files in a distributed system. But I want to leave you with some closing thoughts on the XFS file system. First of all, log-based striping, and particularly subsetting the storage servers over which you stripe the log. That's a technical innovation. The second technical innovation is combining cooperative caching with dynamic management of data and metadata. And the last technical nugget is the distributed log cleaning, making sure that the responsibility for cleaning up the logs from the disk is not left to one node, but it is actually distributed, and especially taking advantage of the fact that the clients who are the mutators for the file system, meaning they are the guys that are writing to the file system, they can keep account of the changes that they're making to the log segments and use that information in the log cleaning effectively.